Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. Today, we will be reading the story Elmer. Elmer is about an elephant named Elmer, and he's not like the other animals. When we read this story, I want you to think about, what does this mean? What can we learn? What does this mean for people, human beings? There once was a herd of elephants. Elephants young, elephants old, elephants tall and short, fat and thin, all were different, but all were happy, and almost all were exactly the same color. All except Elmer. Elmer was not elephant color. He was patchwork. Elmer was yellow and orange and red and pink and purple and blue and green and black and white. It was Elmer who kept the other elephants happy. Their games and jokes were always his idea. If an elephant was laughing, it was usually because of Elmer. But Elmer himself wasn't happy. Who ever heard of a patchwork elephant, he thought. No wonder they laugh at me. One morning, just as the others were waking up, Elmer slipped away. As he walked through the jungle, Elmer met other animals along the way. Good morning, Elmer, they said. After a long walk, Elmer found what he was looking for, a large bush covered in elephant-colored berries. Elmer caught hold of the bush and shook it until the berries fell to the ground. Then Elmer lay down and rolled over the berries this way and that. He picked up bunches of berries and rubbed himself all over until he was covered with the berry juice. When he had finished, there wasn't any sign of any yellow or orange or red or pink or purple or blue or green or black or white. Elmer looked just like any other elephant. On his way back through the jungle, Elmer passed the other animals again. Good morning, elephant, they said. When Elmer rejoined the herd, none of the other elephants noticed him. As he stood there, Elmer felt that something was wrong. But what? He looked around. It was the same old jungle, same old blue sky, same old rain cloud, same old elephants. The other elephants were standing absolutely still, silent and serious. Elmer had never seen them so serious before. It made him want to laugh. Finally, he could bear it no longer. He lifted his trunk and at the top of his voice shouted, "Boo!" The other elephants jumped in surprise. Elmer was helpless with laughter. Then the other elephants began to laugh. Too bad Elmer isn't here to join in this fun, they said, laughing harder and harder. Just then the rain cloud burst. When the rain fell down on Elmer, his patchwork started to show again. Oh, Elmer, gasped an old elephant as Elmer was washed back to normal. You've played some good jokes, but this has been your biggest joke of all. What would we do without you? We must celebrate this day every year, said another elephant. The day of Elmer's best joke. All of us elephants will decorate ourselves in his honor, said a third. And Elmer will decorate himself in ordinary elephant color. And one day each year, the elephants color themselves yellow or orange or red or pink or purple or blue or green or black or white and have a parade. And if you happen to see an elephant in the Elmer's Day Parade who is ordinary elephant color, you know that it must be Elmer. So when we look at all of these elephants and the way that they're decorated in the end of the book, we notice that they've chosen a lot of different colors. And they didn't just paint themselves randomly with colors all over the place, because that might not look very good. They're trying to share something about themselves. They're trying to be individual. And when we look at these things, we will see that they've made what are called patterns, and a pattern is something that repeats. Like this is a repeating polka dot pattern. This is a repeating flower pattern. This is a repeating stripe pattern. Repeating means to do the same thing over and over again. So if we were to make a pattern, we would have to make something that repeats. When we make our elephant, we're going to want to have repeating patterns on it so that it looks cool. So what are we supposed to learn about the story Elmer? In the beginning, Elmer is an elephant, but he doesn't look like his friends. He doesn't look like his family. He doesn't feel like he fits in. But all the other elephants enjoy having him around because he's different, because he's fun, because he has good jokes and games. He feels that when they're laughing at him because he's different, and that makes him sad. It makes him want to walk away and leave the herd. When he leaves the herd, everybody that he passes through the jungle kind of recognizes him. They know what he looks like, so they know who he is. Well, when he covers himself and makes himself look like everyone else, they don't know who he is. They say, "Good morning, elephant." When he comes back to the herd, they don't even know he's there. And in the end, they all end up wanting to be more like him in the way that he is unique and different from everyone else. So this big parade that they have in the end is all about celebrating that they're different from each other and making themselves look as different as possible and unique. Each one of us is a unique person. If we all looked the same, that would be pretty strange. Imagine walking into a classroom and every kid looks exactly the same. Me as the teacher, I wouldn't know your names. I wouldn't know who you are. I would just say, "Hi, kid." "Hi, kid." "Good morning, kid." That would be pretty strange and pretty boring. We wouldn't be able to tell each other apart. There would be very little to talk about or laugh about, and it would just be very boring. So it's good that we're not all exactly the same. The story of Elmer teaches us that we should celebrate how different we are and to appreciate each other's uniqueness or what makes them one of a kind. Today we're going to be making an elephant that does just that. Okay, so to get started, we will want our picture that looks like this with a picture of an elephant on it. We will also want some markers. I'm not going to use black or brown or gray for this project because I want it to look bright colored. You want to first select a dark color. A dark color means anything that's not basically pink or orange or yellow. So those colors, just for right now, are not going to be part of my selection. Any dark color will do. I'm going to choose blue. You will start by getting a nice, thick, solid outline of the elephant. Just a tip. Pun intended. You don't want to draw your outline using the tip of the marker like this. You'll get just a very thin line. This marker has like an edge on it, so if you lean it on its side and you draw it like that, you'll get a nice thick line that's going to stand out better, and it's going to work out better when you go to cut this thing out. So just carefully go around. Give yourself a nice colored, thick outline. The reason why I said to use a dark color is because a light color would not cover the black. If you were to use yellow or orange or pink or something, you'd be able to see the black right through it, and that might not look as good. Do all of the black lines. Once you have that done, you're going to need to divide this elephant into four parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to divide it vertically with lines. Now, if you want to split something into four parts, you need to draw three lines. So draw three lines that go from the top of the animal to the bottom of the animal. So let's start right here. And we'll get ourselves a nice line that goes down and then ends there. Now I have one section here. I'm going to move over and do another one, maybe in the middle. Now I have two sections, and then this big third one. Now I'm going to draw a line that goes from here like that, and now I have the trunk as its own section. This is another section, and so is this and that. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 zones. Now that you're done with that, you can bring back your light colors, add them to your selection of dark colors, and begin making some patterns. When making a pattern, you want to make it as interesting as possible. This can be done by adding more and more layers to something. So if you start with just a very basic pattern like dots or stripes, that's fine as a beginning, but you would want to add as much as you can to that in different layers of repeating dots and lines and shapes and stuff like that, and coloring parts in, because we're trying to make these the best, most creative, coolest looking patterns that we can do. So I'm going to start with something like red, and I'm just going to very simply make some red stripes that follow this curve. That's an okay start, but it's not where I would want to finish. What if I put some dots in here? If I repeat the dot, that's a pattern. So I have a pattern of repeating dots inside that stripe. Now, in order to make this a pattern, I have to repeat it in the other stripes. But I don't have to do it in every single one. I could do it in a pattern of every other one. So what if I put orange dots in this one and an orange dot in this one? Now it goes orange dots and then no orange dots, orange dots and then no orange dots. I think that looks better than it did before. So if adding one thing made it better, I wonder if adding a second thing would make it even better still. What if I did this and added these triangular repeating shapes here with green? I think that got better. So if adding two things made it better, I would ask the question, do you think adding a third would make it even better than that? There's only one way to find out, to test and see. Maybe this time I'll take purple and I'll add a line of dots that runs right along that edge in every other one. I like the way that looks. And maybe I'll take red. No, I'll take, yeah, I'll take red, sure. And I'll outline all my dots, my orange dots, with red. I like the way that looks. I think I'm ready to move on to my next space. So when you've added enough things and enough layers to the repeating pattern, then you can move on. I'm going to start with some lines of orange. And I'm just going to go top to bottom. Okay, that's all right looking. Maybe I'll go across them this way. That's an okay start, but once again, I don't want to end there. I want to keep going. See if there's more that could be done. What if I put like a yellow thick line going up through here? And then I made one going this way, like this. And I'm doing that in every other space. Just to be clear, you don't have to make yours look exactly like mine. I'm just showing you some examples of patterns so that you would get an idea of what kinds of things you could do. The point is not for you to copy me exactly. That might be something that you do in a different class where you're trying to learn something very specific, but in art class, that's usually not how we do things. point is for you to learn how to make things that you want to make. My job is to guide you and give you ideas and inspiration. So think of it that way. I'm going to add some purple to this pattern because I think it could use it. So every other one, I'm just going to do purple. Going up and down, and then I think I'm going to add some blue right in the middle of each yellow horizontal stripe. Add some blue. See how that affects it. See if that makes it any better. Okay, I like the way this is looking. I'm going to add a bit more color. Sometimes when you're just adding dots and lines, and you're not actually coloring anything in, you still have a lot of white, and the picture doesn't look as colorful as you may want it to. But by coloring in spaces, you can add more color, overall color, to the picture itself, and it makes it look better. Don't worry if you get something outside the line like this, because you will be cutting this out. So the object of today is to just very simply get started. And let's shoot for two patterns today. So get your outline done and make two of the best patterns that you can. Then you can take a picture of that and submit that for today's part of the assignment.